Hi everyone, happy 4th of July. Hope you guys are having a safe and fun holiday. We're actually just gonna stay home today and grill tonight. So I'm headed out to the garden grocery store to pick a few things for our dinner. We're actually gonna start over in the container garden. It's gonna be a fun time. It's super warm here today. It's probably gonna be around 90 degrees. So covering up the garden with shade and grilling tonight will be a fun way to celebrate. Here in the container garden, I have my very first cucumbers to harvest. I'm very excited about this. I love cucumbers, so come on over and take a look. A lot of you are following along with the container garden series. It's been so much fun. And here we go, the first cucumber of the season. It is a beauty. This is a Space Master cucumber. It's a container-friendly variety, and I'm not too sure how we're gonna eat this. Maybe we'll slice it up, have it with some hummus. This one's not going on the grill. I have been making a really good whipped feta dip lately, so I think this would be a great addition to that, maybe on top of some grilled bread. And I do have another one to harvest right over here. Now, first of all, before I move on to the next one though, I wanted to show you guys, my cucumber plant is starting to get some powdery mildew. So I'm a little bit concerned about that. I do need to get out here today and spray this with my powdery mildew milk water spray. So you can check out that video, but I'll probably have to unfortunately remove all of these leaves. They're looking really, really nice, but those powdery mildew spots are not good. So hoping to do another video on that in the next week or so. And we will be doing a video on some container garden tips on maintaining your container garden. Super excited about the growth here. No Tiny Tim tomatoes yet to harvest, but look at all the flowers. So the tomatoes should be coming along soon. So here in the smart pots here, we've got another Space Master cucumber. Now you can pick cucumbers at 4 to 6 inches or so, but just experiment, pick them at the size that you like the best. And you don't wanna let them get too large because then they do tend to get bitter, but this one is the perfect size. Cannot wait to eat this on a hot summer day. It's gonna be so refreshing. Now here on the wall saddle planters, I know we've got a couple strawberries to harvest. At least we have one to harvest. If you watched our video a few weeks ago, we put these wall saddle planters in. It's a great way to make use of your deck rail and grow in every inch of space that you can in your small space containers. And we popped in these strawberries. This is one of the most delectable strawberries I've ever seen. See that beautiful red shine? It has no white spots along the top, and this is perfectly ready to harvest. We might have to dip this in chocolate and have it tonight for dessert. Oh my goodness. This just looks amazing. It's so much fun to come out to the garden grocery store and harvest dinner. And there's a lot more flowers on these strawberries, so I know we'll have a lot more strawberries coming soon. And I think I'm actually gonna grab a few leaves of this purple kale. It is just so beautiful. What a joy and reward to be able to harvest and grow your own food. We're gonna head down to the main garden in just a moment. I know I have a few things, fun things to harvest down there, but before we do, I'm gonna grab some of this basil here because I think this will go on top of our grilled veggies. Now you wanna pick basil before it starts to flower. And you can see there's little flower buds just starting to come up here, because once it flowers, the flavor changes and then it has stalks kind of tend to get woody. So what I'm going to do is clip my basil right below this first set of leaves here. And the more you prune basil, the more it grows, and you'll see new growth coming from your basil within just a couple of weeks or so. Keeps it healthy and keeps it growing. And there's nothing like grilled veggies with fresh basil. It's so, so tasty. I just want to show you guys real quick how beautifully these beans are growing in the purple Calicim smart pots. These beans are getting so tall, and there's no flowers or fruit on here yet, but I think they will be coming out very soon. But I have been keeping this sprayed with the neem peppermint rosemary oil. Usually I get really bad spider mites on my beans, but these are looking super, super healthy. So stay tuned for a harvest on that. I want to show you guys real quick here. There are some little Tiny Tim tomatoes coming on this plant. Now I need to put one of my little tree branch stakes in this plant, but look here, guys, which means we're going to have new tiny Tim tomatoes coming on very soon. And oh, there's a bunch up here too. Wow. This is an amazing patio vegetable. Grows to about 2 feet tall. It's a dwarf tomato. And it's growing beautifully. It really loves growing in these black Cali Kim 5 gallon smart pots. So get yourself a container garden growing. It's not too late. It's so much fun to grow your own garden grocery store right outside your kitchen door. So let's head on to the main garden and see what we have to harvest down there. There's not a ton to harvest on the hill here. I got things planted a little bit late. We've had a lot of cool, cloudy, overcast days, but today is gonna be hot. So after we're done filming this video, I'm gonna be covering the entire hill with shade cloth. But I know we do have a little treasure right down here at the bottom, which we are gonna throw on the grill tonight. It's gonna be so tasty because it's the first one of the season. Any guesses? Well, we are right here at this plant a few weeks ago when we filmed organic pest control. If you guess zucchini, you are right. Look at that beauty. That is actually a black beauty zucchini. It is the perfect size for harvesting, maybe 8 inches long. It's gonna be super, super tender. And to harvest zucchini, you wanna harvest it young, unless you like the really big zucchini, which you can use for zucchini lasagna. But I like to just gently twist it to snap the stem off at the bottom here. I don't like to use a knife because sometimes I inadvertently cut some of the branches here. So just gently twist it off. And I have really been hankering for some grilled squash. So this is gonna be so, so good. We're gonna flavor it with some fresh herbs from the garden. Now, this one over here is a crookneck squash, and there are quite a few squash coming on here. So those will probably be ready to harvest within a week or so. Lots of flowers. Male flowers, female flowers, a nice warm day today. The bees are gonna be out pollinating, so I fully expect those squash to grow within the next week. And I wanted to show you one right down here, unless it got eaten and disappeared overnight. Oh, here it is. Not sure if this one got pollinated, but look at this, is kind of unusual. There's two squash that are kind of growing together and kind of merged together. So we'll have to see if that grows into anything. So here on the strawberry crate tower, we've been harvesting strawberries off here for a couple of weeks, but there are a few I'm gonna pick. Nice and red and shiny and juicy. So, so tasty. Now, strawberries don't like temperatures over 85 degrees, so you really do need to shade your strawberries in the heat. And what I've done is I've just attached a piece of shade cloth to the back of the crate tower with a clip. That way, anytime it gets hot, I can just throw it over and make quick work out of it. So let me just look here the rest of the tower, see if we have any more berries. We definitely have some coming on the bottom, which will probably ripen up within the next week or so. Here's a little teeny tiny one that's a little bit misshapen, but you know what? A berry is a berry. If you guys caught my This Week in the Garden video a couple of days ago, you saw this lovely trellis that I'm super excited about, a wooden kind of ladder trellis. Now, when I showed you that video, I had just planted these cucumber seeds about a week ago and they had not come up yet. Look what happened just in the past couple of days. These are the lemon cucumber from the cucumber seed collection. And here we have the long green improved, the Boston pickling. So they just came up in the past couple of days. I love seeing little seedlings bust through the soil. I get so excited about it. And I cannot wait for this trellis to be covered with cucumbers. It is just gonna be so much fun. I'm gonna point to this purple smart pots right over here. I planted some scallop squash in it maybe, I don't know, a month or so ago, and it is growing like crazy. I know I'm gonna have to thin those out. Cannot wait to harvest scallop squash. It is one of my absolute favorite varieties. It's so, so pretty. But here in this 20 gallon smart pots, we have got our first crookneck squash ready to harvest. So we're gonna throw this on the grill tonight with the zucchini. Oh my goodness, it is gonna be a beautiful, colorful grill tonight. Oh, this is just so exciting. I love harvesting my own fresh, tasty vegetables. So I'm gonna throw this in our harvest basket and look around and see if we have anything else. Oh, I wanted to get some dill. That'll be a nice little combination. I am just going to throw all the herbs I can into the bowl with the chopped vegetables. Camera guy's going to throw it on the grill tonight. And we might not be able to show that grilling in the video because we want to get this posted for you guys today. But I'll post a picture over on my Instagram, CalliKim29. So make sure you head over there to check that out. And I think I might have one tomato right behind me. Into the Scarlet Runner Beans arch. It's so cozy in here. I love coming in here. It's nice and cool. I do have to be careful where I step though, camera guy, because I have some beans growing in the middle, which I'm training to grow up over this arch. So watch out where you step. But you know what? Here is one little lone tomato. It's kind of misshapen and it looks really funny, but I'm gonna go ahead and pick it. It's growing from a Smart Pots right outside the arch, and I've been training it up and over the arch. So don't worry too much if your tomatoes look like this. Mine do too sometimes, and they're still very edible. I am absolutely dying for my tomatoes to come in this year. They seem to be really slow, I think due to the fact I got them planted late, and we've had a lot of cloudy weather. So I am dying for some fresh tomatoes. So this one we will definitely enjoy tonight. Now, while I'm in here, I'm gonna look for some Scarlet Runner beans. I did pick some the other day, so I don't know if I have any ready to harvest, but if you've ever grown beans before, you know that they grow so fast and you have to check them almost every day or they really get quite large. Now this one, I don't think it's a Scarlet Runner bean. I think it's a Kentucky Wonder pole bean. A little bit on the big side, but we're gonna take it off. And I think this one will still be edible. Let me look for some Scarlet Runners. We might have some around the other side. So let's go around the front and see if we have a few we can pick over there. So I wanna come around the other side of the arch here. Camera guy actually just alerted me to the fact that there is one giant Scarlet Runner bean right here. And doesn't that look amazing? Now, Scarlet Runner beans really should be picked when they're much, much smaller. But I've missed a couple days coming out here to check. So this one got out of hand, but wait till you see these beans. They are so beautiful. You guys are gonna love these. These can actually be dried and just kept in a jar and then boiled and used like you would for refried beans or just, you know, boiled and put them on a salad. Aren't these beautiful? Oh my goodness. So, so pretty. Well, hopefully we have some smaller ones around the other side that maybe we can throw into our grilled vegetables tonight. So let's go take a look. Scarlet Runner beans are beautiful red flowers along with the beans and are great for attracting the pollinators. The bees love them, the butterflies love them. We see tons of hummingbirds buzzing around. So if we're lucky, maybe we'll see some here while we're shooting. So this is actually just the right size for Scarlet Runners. You can actually pick them even a little bit younger than that or smaller than that, but this will be super tasty. Once they get to this size, they do get a little bit stringy. And then I do like to grow them just for the beans themselves, not necessarily for the bean pods. Let's go ahead and clip these off. And when you're harvesting beans, it's a good idea to check under the vines because they do like to hide. So you want to kind of pull things back. Yep, here's one hiding right here. And you don't want to just yank them off the vine. I like to just snip them with a pair of scissors or pruners. Here's a bunch of little tiny ones coming on here, and literally I'm gonna have to come out here and check, which will be fun, in 1 to 2 days, and these will probably grow to size by then. So let me just check under here real good to see if any are hiding. Really need to train these vines up and over. Usually they grab on really well, but our trees are growing up over the arch, so I may have to get up on a ladder. Here we go. Oh, this is a tiny one. I love those. Oh, this one's perfect. And these are some of the most tender beans I've ever had. I just like to boil them in a little bit of salted water, little bit of butter, salt and pepper, and they're absolutely perfect. And you want to boil them just until they're tender, maybe 3 to 5 minutes, and then check them with a fork to make sure they're not getting too soft. You guys will love these. And these are all in my bean seed collection. So easy to grow. Not too late to get them started, but you are going to need a pretty large trellis if you want them to be really productive for you. They also make a great ornamental plant and a little privacy hedge as well. Oh, here's a couple hiding under here. I love coming out here in the morning and checking to see if things need harvesting. So much fun to reap the rewards of all of the work in the garden. I think that might be about it for the day for the beans. Now let me just show you where that tomato is coming from that we picked around the back of the trellis. Growing here in this pot, the 5 gallon, or no, I think it's a 15 gallon smart pots. And this tomato plant actually overwintered, and I probably will take it out pretty soon. I want to put something that's going to be a little more productive in. But you can see it's just growing up here into the trellis and then back through here. So yeah, I don't know exactly what I'll put in its place, but we'll find something yummy for sure. So if you saw my Instagram post this week, I talked about these midnight snack tomatoes. These are so, so beautiful. They ripen to a purple kind of reddish color. I do have another ripe one here. Actually, it's not quite ripe. I might leave that a couple more days. Because when it's ripe, the bottom turns a beautiful red, and then the top is that absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous purple color. So really enjoying the midnight snacks this season. Oh, here's one that's, I think, pretty ripe. Look at that, isn't that pretty? This is an All America Selections winner, and it's the first year I've grown them, and they're called Midnight Snack for a reason, because you can snack on them right in the garden. So tasty. Mmm. Oh, that fresh tomato flavor. Oh my goodness, it's so good. Now I'm growing red burgundy okra, which I've shared with you guys. Okra is not my favorite vegetable in the world, but the plant is absolutely gorgeous. And let me just show you how things are growing here. And who knows, we might even have some little okra starting to come on. So you can see how beautiful the leaves are. The stems are absolutely stunning. And the flowers, we don't have any flowers quite yet, which means no okra yet, but the flowers look like a tropical kind of flower. So if you aren't growing okra and you live in a hot climate, they absolutely love, love, love the heat. Highly recommend it. These are in my spring garden seed collection, but I think we should be getting some okra very soon, because I think the flowers are just getting ready to pop through. So that'll be really fun. And I'm loving all the okra recipes that you guys have been sending me in the comments and emailing me. That's been a lot of fun. You guys know how I absolutely love my peppers, and I'm gonna harvest one of these. This is a new variety to me. This is called an Escomillo pepper. It's another All America Selections variety. Super, super tasty. Look at the size of this. This is a green one that's not quite ready to harvest, but what a beautiful, beautiful pepper. So I'm gonna take this orange one here. Now, you can harvest peppers at different stages. You can see this one's got some green coloring still in it, which I think is really, really pretty. So, or I could wait till it's completely orange, which is the color that it's meant to be. But you know what? Try harvesting at different stages. See what you like. There's no one set thing to do for peppers, because they're always, always changing. And these are so tasty on the grill. We had one a couple of weeks ago, nice and blackened, where the skin was kind of bubbling up. Oh my goodness, my mouth is watering now. Now, this one here is my California Wonder Pepper, which I absolutely love, one of my favorite little peppers. And I love how it looks here on this red little gardener's tomato ladder. It's one section of the tomato ladder. Now, these peppers are supposed to ripen to a beautiful bright red color, but I'm gonna go ahead and pick this one now, and I'll tell you guys why. See how it's getting a little bit soft right here, and the skin is a little bit wrinkled? We've had a couple days of pretty warm temperatures, and it's starting to get sun scald. Sun scald is almost like a little sunburn for your peppers. So I'd really rather wait till the whole thing is red, but you know what? It's gonna be tasty on the grill anyway. We're gonna go ahead and take it. And then I'm gonna shade these plants today with some shade cloth, because I'd like these ones to ripen to a really nice, beautiful red color. Now I'm also going to grab some chives here. I love chives snipped onto vegetables or into dips. Chives are a perennial herb. They grow better in cooler weather, but they are growing okay in the California summer, because we have had a little bit of cooler weather this summer. And look, they're flowering. The flowers are also edible. Chives also do really well with regular pruning, so I'm going to give them a little haircut. And the cool thing about chives is you can cut them way, way back, and they grow back very, very quickly. Now, typically we'll snip these into scrambled eggs on top of salads. Oh, I wish you guys could smell this. It smells absolutely amazing. But tonight we're gonna clip them or snip them onto our roasted vegetables. Camera guy's grilling up a tri-tip, and this is gonna be a great addition. Maybe I'll even make some bread that we can grill up as well, which would be super, super tasty on the bread. I've gotta show you guys how quickly the cantaloupe is growing. Just the other day, I wanna say it was maybe half that size. And a lot of people asked, how do you support that on a trellis? Well, stay tuned. We'll be doing a video on this one very soon, it looks like. Okay. I cannot wait until my eggplant are ready to harvest. This is an Ikebana eggplant. I think I showed you guys on the June garden tour. These are growing so incredibly quickly, but I don't think they're quite ready. I didn't even see that one yesterday. So that's a new little one that's just popped out. Here is the Ikebana. Finger kind of shape, I guess you would say, but this is a beautiful plant. I love the flowers. It's so, so pretty. And eggplant are one of my very, very favorite vegetables to have on the grill. So we'll be harvesting that one probably within a couple of days. A couple more peppers over here to harvest. Some hot peppers. Now, these peppers are not looking so great, unfortunately. A lot of yellowing leaves. So I did give them a good little dose of good dirt plant food in case it's some type of nitrogen deficiency. But yellowing leaves can also be caused by underwatering, overwatering. So hopefully we'll do course correction on these and all will be well. But they're still putting off some peppers. This is another All America Selections variety. I love growing those because they're always super productive. This one is a pepper with a mild heat called Aji Rico. So let me know if you've grown that one before. So we'll have a little bit of heat to our grilled vegetables tonight, but Jerry doesn't like a lot of heat, so maybe I'll just put these on mine. And this is my first harvest of these. I think these are really pretty little peppers. Got a red one. This one's kind of on the orange side. And a lot of times the longer you leave them on the plant, the hotter they get. So we'll see about that one. And this pepper here, oh dear, no tag. Not too sure what variety it is, but I'm pretty sure it's a hot one. The pepper back at the very back of the planter here, this is one of the Cayenne Long Slims from the Pepper Seed Collection. I actually thought this plant was dead. I cut it way back over the winter time. There are absolutely no leaves on it, and look how beautifully it's coming back. It overwintered absolutely beautifully, and there are a ton of little tiny red long Cayenne Slims. Looks like this one's even left over from the winter time. It's drying up. So we'll be harvesting these over the summer and making some super fire hot salsa. Pretty excited about how my harvest basket is looking so far. I think we've got a couple more little red ripe strawberries here. Now, if you watched my This Week in the Garden, I mentioned how I'm redoing the strawberry crate towers. This tower is one of the originals, 5 years old, so it is looking pretty ratty here. But we do have a couple strawberries ready to pick, and these plants are really gonna take off once I transplant them. The soil in here is getting kind of compacted. They're in this old landscape fabric, which is fine, but they're gonna do much better in the Smart Pots crate liners. I'm gonna give them a nice little boost, and then these plants will really take off. So I'm really hoping to do that this week, and hopefully it'll be on next week's In the Garden video, which, by the way, thanks for all your great comments on that. I think we are gonna make it a regular part of our channel because so many people enjoyed it. So let me look down in here and see if we've got any more. I think we're pretty good on this one.
Oh, I see one.
Oh, you see one?
Look at that.
Oh, that looks nice. You know what? I'm actually going to leave that for a couple more days.
Not quite red enough, right?
Not quite ready. See, there, it's still a little bit light colored there. So it'll be a lot better and a lot sweeter in a couple of days. But I think I've got a few on the tower right over here. And by the way, guys, thanks so much for all your comments and suggestions on what to do with this whole red planter area. I'm really excited to implement some of them. So we've got a couple over here. You know what? These might be a little bit overripe, but we'll pick them anyway because we'd rather have them than have the birds or the bugs have them. And let me check in the top. You really do have to look into the top of your towers. You can see these really need trimming down. Strawberries really do benefit from a lot of pruning. You need that good airflow. So this week, guess what my job is? To come in here and clean out some of this dead stuff up here. And maybe that'll help these babies take off. Oh, here's another one down here. Jerry, what do you think? Is that one ready?
Yes.
Well,
maybe not.
I'm going to say no. And here's why. Look at how the bottom is still kind of white. And it doesn't have that glossy red.
Compared to those reds.
Let me find my favorite one of the day here. Compared to this one, look at the difference in the red. So we're going to leave that one. We'll come back and check on it in a couple of days. And by the way, guys, Mac really enjoyed all your positive comments about his little trick. On This Week in the Garden, you saw him jump over here. He's pretty proud of that trick. So here we've got some cherry tomatoes. This is kind of my holding area. I told you guys on my June garden tour, I stuck my extra seedlings in here and they're kind of my backup. So if one plant fails, I'll have these to kind of put out in the garden. So I don't put a ton of effort into these, but we do have a couple cherry tomatoes. So I may have to make that whipped feta up on the grilled sourdough and throw these on top of there. Look at these beautiful babies. I think these are the large red cherry from the tomato seed collection. Could be maybe a tad bit riper, but since I'm dying for tomatoes, I am gonna pick them. Couple little tiny ones here. I think these are the Candyland Red, an American All America Selections variety. And the blackberries. I gotta dig around in the blackberries. I might have a few that are ready, I'm not sure. I watered this whole area down with worm tea about a week or so ago, the Vermistera worm tea. And I'm telling you guys, the very next day, I think I saw more blackberries popping out. That stuff works wonders. And they definitely started ripening up after that. So here we go. One of the first blackberries of the season. I think we picked the first one on the June garden tour. So you can see the difference in color here. Here's the ones that aren't ripe. They don't pull from the vine easily at all. The ones that are ripe, that beautiful black shiny color, and they pull so easily off the plant. Oh my goodness, absolutely gorgeous. I'm gonna put it here with the strawberries, and I think we're gonna have to have these for breakfast, no doubt about it, over some Greek yogurt, which is one of my favorite ways to eat it.
Sounds
with some fresh local honey.
Sounds really good.
And yes, it does sound delicious. It is already getting hot. Now, blackberries also like to hide under leaves. I found these. Oh my goodness. Delectable,
yeah.
Absolutely delectable.
Wow.
These are ripe and ready for the eating. That one came off a little bit hard. Oh, that one just fell right off. Beautiful little handful. And I'm gonna grab one here off camera that I just saw.
Huh.
Okay, let me lift up these leaves, see if there's any more. These are looking so pretty here, just starting to turn black. It is gonna be a good blackberry year. I have a really good feeling about this. Blackberry cobbler, here we come. I've gotta grab some sage from this garden bed, so this is a good chance to give you guys a closer look of the flagstone path I mentioned in This Week in the Garden. The flagstone was repurposed. We actually had it on our wall by our fireplace, believe it or not, when we first moved into our house. We tore it out and put it here in its place. Let me know what you guys think. So here's the sage plant. Again, I'm gonna pack these roasted squash here, or grilled squash, with as much herbs as I can. So I'm gonna grab some sage from this area. And I'm kind of debating whether or not I should take this sage plant out because I don't really need quite this much sage, but I have sage in another part of my garden. However, the bees love the purple flowers. So I'm kind of debating what to do. Let me know what you guys think. One more thing to harvest, and that is rosemary. You can't have grilled squash without some rosemary. So let's go grab some. The rosemary bush is kind of getting out of control, but it does give me lots of rosemary for herbs, for all kinds of yummy things. So we're gonna snip some off here. Now this does need pruning back. And typically what I do with this big rosemary bush is I just get my electric hedge trimmers out and prune it back. Believe it or not, this has been growing here for about 7 or 8 years. It started from one of those little teeny tiny nursery pots that you get at the garden center, and it just grows out of control. You can propagate rosemary. You can put it in water with a little bit of worm tea. It will grow roots for a new plant. So if you don't have any rosemary, grab a soft cutting here that doesn't have a real woody stem from a neighbor or a friend. Pop it in water, And I've got a video on how to do that. It usually takes a couple of weeks to root. I can't even tell you guys how heavenly this smells out here. It is just absolutely amazing. So grab a whole bunch. One thing I've been using rosemary for is to marinate, to put some on top of chicken, marinate it with lemon. The chicken with lemon and rosemary and sage. Oh my goodness, so amazing on the grill. Now, a lot of you have been asking about the grapevine. I actually did absolutely nothing to the grapevine. I have every good intention to trim it back this winter, but it got neglected. In spite of that, let me show you guys what's growing. Real quick before we finish our harvest video, we'll come back in here. Now, I'm very hopeful that the critters don't get these grapes. But look what we've got. In spite of our neglect, we have 3 or 4 or 5 bunches of really nice looking grapes that are starting to turn. Can you believe this, Jerry?
It's hilarious. The time that we don't do anything with them, they come up.
I know. Isn't that just the way nature works sometimes?
But I have a feeling if we wait too long.
I know. We got to keep an eye on these. The minute they start to turn and go red, we got to get out here and pick them and do a video.
That's the story everybody tells too. They wait too long, you know, you think, oh, one more day, and then they're gone. They get eaten overnight, it seems.
They do. All right. And I'm going to check one of these and see how sweet or sour it is. Yeah. It's still a little bit sour, but it's got a hint of sweetness. So I'm thinking, I don't know, maybe within a couple of weeks. So stay tuned. Harvesting is always one of my favorite parts of gardening. We're going to really enjoy barbecuing these up tonight for the 4th of July. Comment below, let me know what you're harvesting from your garden, and have a safe and happy 4th. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next video.